Geobyte.
Hi students, welcome to the Geobyte Diploma series. In this video, we are going to discuss force exerted by a jet on a curved fixed plate. Under that case, first let us take the jet is entering to the center of the plate like this. The jet is entering to the center of the plate with a velocity v. Though the jet is entering horizontally, once the jet is hitting the plate, half of the jet is moving down like this. The remaining half jet is moving up like this. Look at the jet leaving direction. The jet is leaving with a velocity v. For a fixed plate condition, jet velocity cannot be changed. The jet is leaving with a velocity v at an angle, let it be theta, with respect to horizontal. Then it is developing two component of velocities. This is the horizontal component of velocity v cos theta, and this is the vertical component of velocity v sin theta. I hope you got my point. Since the jet is leaving from the plate with a velocity v at an angle theta, is developing two component of velocities, horizontal component of velocity and vertical component of velocity. Now the force along the jet direction. Force along x direction means force in x direction is equal to rho a v into v1 x minus v2 x, where v1 x equal to velocity of the jet at state 1. This is the state 1 and this is the state 2. Where v1x equal to velocity of the jet at state 1 along x direction, that is equal to v only. Similarly, v2x equal to velocity of the jet at state 2 along x direction. Look at the v2x direction. V2x direction is in this direction. V2x direction is in this direction. So v cos theta. V is in this direction, that is taken as positive. V cos theta is acting opposite to that one, therefore it is minus v cos theta. Now the force along x direction fx equal to rho a v. V1x is v, v2x is minus of minus v cos theta. Simplify this value for getting rho a v into v plus v cos theta. It is equal to rho a v square into 1 plus cos theta. That is the formula for deciding force along x direction. That is the force when the jet is entering to the center of the curved fixed plate. For example, if the jet is entering at one end, case 2, jet is at one end. The jet is entering to the one end of the plate. Then listen carefully. This is your plate. This is your plate. The jet may be entering at one end like this. The jet may be entering at one end with a velocity v. since the plate is fixed, plate velocity u equal to 0. Since the jet is entering with a velocity v at an angle, let it be theta, developing two component of velocities, this is the horizontal component of velocity p cos theta and this is the vertical component of velocity v sin theta. After the jet of water is traveling over the surface of the water, the jet of water is leaving in this direction with a velocity v. For the fixed plate condition, already I told you jet velocity cannot be changed. Since the jet is leaving from the plate at an angle phi, developing two component of velocities, this is the horizontal component of velocity v cos phi and vertical component of velocity v sin phi. Now let us find the v1x. V1x equal to velocity of the jet at state 1 along x direction, that is v cos theta. V2x, velocity of the jet at state 2 along x direction, that is minus v cos phi. The reason why we took minus is the v1x is v cos theta. V cos theta is acting in this direction. V cos phi is acting in this direction. That's why I wrote v cos theta is positive. V cos phi is minus. Then force along x direction. Force along x direction, Fx equal to general formula rho Av into V1x minus V2x. That is the force along x direction. Fx equal to rho Av. Here V1x equal to V cos theta. V2x equal to minus of minus V cos phi. Simplify this value, rho Av into V cos theta minus of minus plus V cos phi. Now, this is the V cos theta. Let me write once again. There is a printing mistake. V cos theta minus of minus plus V cos phi. Plus V cos phi. It is equal to rho Av square into cos theta plus cos phi. That is the formula for deciding the force along x direction. I hope you got my point. For this case, work done is equal to 0 because work done equal to force multiplied by blade speed. Here blade speed is 0, blade is not moving, that's why work done equal to 0. I hope you got my point. Next concept is force exerted by jet on a moving curved vane. Let us take the curved vane, which is mobile type, and from the nozzle a jet of high velocity is leaving in this direction. That high velocity jet is maintaining the velocity v1. Since the jet is maintaining the velocity v1 at an angle alpha, developing two component of velocities, this is the vertical component of velocity, this is the horizontal component of velocity. Horizontal component of velocity at inlet denoted by VW1. This VW1 is nothing but V1 cos alpha and this is the vertical component of velocity Vf1, that Vf1 is equal to V1 sin alpha. This is the horizontal component of velocity direction. Now, by receiving the jet energy, the plate may be moving with a velocity u. Since the plate is moving horizontally according to our diagram, the plate velocity should be marked on the horizontal line. So this may be the AD, may be the plate speed denoted by u. Here jet is entering with a velocity V1, plate is moving with a velocity u, then the jet can catch the plate with relative velocity. That relative velocity is the vector difference between V1 and u. Since the jet is moving, plate is moving, then the jet can catch the plate with relative velocity. That relative velocity is the vector difference between V1 and u. That relative velocity may be marked by Vr1, and this is the blade inlet angle theta. Theta by the blade inlet angle. So that is the inlet triangle. Come to the outlet triangle. Assume the jet is leaving. Jet is leaving with a velocity V2. The jet is leaving with a velocity V2. At an angle beta. At an angle beta. Since the jet is leaving with a velocity V2 at an angle beta, developing two component of velocities. This is the vertical component of velocity Vf2 equal to V2 sin beta, and this is the horizontal component of velocity Vw2 is V2 cos beta. And this may be the blade speed. This may be the blade speed u. Then the speed connecting between the jet V2 and u be the relative velocity. Practically the jet is leaving with respect to relative velocity only. This is the relative velocity at outlet Vr2, and this is the blade exit angle phi. Phi be the blade exit angle. This is the outlet triangle. Outlet triangle. So this is the inlet triangle. Inlet triangle. Let me write the notations. Vw1 equal to horizontal component of velocity. Horizontal component of velocity at inlet. At inlet, Vf1 equal to vertical component of velocity, vertical component of velocity at inlet. Alpha equal to jet angle with the velocity, with the velocity V1. U equal to blade speed. U equal to blade speed. Theta equal to blade inlet angle. Theta equal to blade inlet angle. And Vr1 equal to relative velocity, relative velocity at inlet. Inlet. Similarly, Vw2 equal to horizontal component of velocity, horizontal component of velocity at outlet. At outlet. Vf2 equal to vertical component of velocity at outlet. VR2 equal to relative velocity at outlet. VF2 completed. Then beta equal to jet leaving angle. Jet leaving angle with a velocity V2. Phi equal to blade outlet angle. Theta by the blade inlet angle. Phi by the blade outlet angle. Then force acts on the plate. F equal to mass flow rate of the water into VW1 plus or minus VW2. You take it as a general formula. Since the plate is moving horizontally, that means horizontal component of velocity is causing for driving the plate. That's why I took the horizontal component of velocity at inlet plus or minus horizontal component of velocity at outlet. Here mass flow rate equal to mass flow rate of the water equal to rho into A into V1. Is giving the mass flow rate of the water. It is in kg per second. VW1 equal to whirl velocity or horizontal component of velocity at inlet. VW2 equal to horizontal component of velocity or whirl velocity, WHIRL, whirl velocity at outlet. That is how you can decide the force on the plate. Then work done per second. Is nothing but power. That power P equal to force multiplied by distance moved by the plate. So force is mass of the water into VW1 plus or minus VW2 into U. When should be taken positive sign and when should be taken negative sign, I will discuss clearly at the time of solving the problems. Now the efficiency. Eta equal to power by kinetic energy of the water per second. Power is mass flow rate of the water into VW1 plus or minus VW2 into U divided by half mass of the water per second into V1 square. The mass of the water per second will be cancelled. These two quantities cancelled. Finally, it will be 2 goes up, 2U into VW1 plus or minus VW2 divided by V1 square into 100. That is how you can decide the efficiency of the system when the jet of water is entering, to the curved movable plate at one end. So with this, dear students, I am concluding this video. In the next video, we will solve numericals. In the very next video, we will solve some important problems. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe our GeoByte channel, and please share these videos to all your diploma friends, whoever is doing in mechanical and civil branches. Thank you very much. Have a great day. GeoByte.